So there were three females of brown-banded bamboo sharks here at the Academy, and they were acquired in 2007 from the Aquarium of the Pacific. And what happened is that one of those females actually produced one egg that started developing normally. There were no males here, and in January 2012, that pup was born. At first, we thought that this was a case of parthenogenesis. Parthenogenesis is known in popular literature as virgin birth. And what happens in parthenogenesis is that there's one unfertilized egg that actually starts developing normally until it becomes a pup. Parthenogenesis is actually really common in the natural world, but when we did the genetic testing, what we did is that we compared the three females with that pup, and we actually found that the pup was the most dissimilar organism of the three. It was so dissimilar that we couldn't even tell which of the females was the mother, and we think that that genetic information actually came from a father. That's where the story gets really interesting, because what we think happened is that the female actually stored sperm from one of the males of the Aquarium of the Pacific for a really long period of time. Actually, sperm storage, it's not a well-known strategy, but it's fairly common for insects, and in the case of vertebrates, it happens very often in snakes. And this is really exciting, because what we think happened is that one female stored sperm for 45 months, and that's the longest amount of time that we know any shark storing sperm. So these two strategies are actually found in solitary species, in which encounters between males and females are actually very rare. In the case of sharks, there's a lot of questions about conservation when we touch this topic of parthenogenesis and sperm storage. And the reason behind this is that with dwindling shark populations, encounters between males and females may actually become even more rare. And in those cases, a lot of scientists think that parthenogenesis might become more common. If parthenogenesis becomes more common, you may have a population with several individuals, but all those individuals are gonna be very, very similar to each other. That means that genetic diversity is actually gonna be very, very reduced. So sperm storage is actually a strategy that allows the maintenance of that healthy genetic diversity that's gonna help sharks to be here on planet Earth for many more years to come.